Hi there. So we are continue learning about Earth and human activity. This video is specifically about natural resources. It goes along with your guided notes. Our learning objectives are that I can define natural resources and identify common, renewable, and non-renewable resources. And I can use evidence to explain that humans depend on many limited natural resources that may not be renewed over human lifetimes. Okay, so on your guided notes, all of the things you'll be needing to fill in are going to be in this red text or red font. So starting with the definition of natural resources. Natural resources are things, materials, substances, and components found in the natural environment. Natural resources exist naturally or innately in the world. They are not the result of human manipulation or creation. So, natural resources can be living or non-living. Some examples are plants, animals, rocks, and minerals are all natural resources. The sun, fossil fuels, soil, water, and wind are all natural resources as well. We use natural resources for many things. We use energy from natural resources for transportation, to generate electricity, to manufacture products. We use natural resources for food. These resources, specifically plants and animals, provide energy that fuels our body. And we use natural resources to construct houses, buildings, and roads. There are two kinds of natural resources. The first one is renewable resources, and the second one is non-renewable resources. Renewable resources can regenerate if they are living or replenished by biochemical cycles if they're not living. Theoretically, there is an infinite amount of renewable resources. Some examples are water, sunlight, plants, animals, and wind are all renewable resources. On the other hand, non-renewable resources cannot be regenerated or replenished by natural processes. There is a finite amount of non-renewable resources. Once used up, they are forever gone. Fossil fuels, which are things like coal, oil, and natural gas, minerals, and metals are all non-renewable resources, meaning that they can run out. Renewable resources can become non-renewable resources if they are used up faster than they can be replenished or replaced. If the resource no longer exists, there's nothing to regenerate or be replenished. For example, if we cut down trees faster than what we grow them, trees can become a non-renewable resource because there are no more trees to regenerate. Okay, this slide isn't on your guided notes. It's just some background information on synthetic products. So we use our natural resources to make synthetic products. Synthetic products are man-made materials and substances. Synthetic products are artificial or they're fake. They do not exist naturally in the environment, right? We make them. We can make synthetic products from plants and animals, as well as from metals, minerals, and other natural resources that are found within Earth. Okay, so on this portion of your guided notes, where it says plant-based products, you only need to provide one example. There are three here for you. So plant-based products that are synthetic products made from plants. Some examples, plants can be used to make food, things like wheat, corn, sugarcane are plants. We use parts of these plants as ingredients to make foods such as bread, chips, and cookies. Plants can be used to make medicine. Many medicines that treat pain, acne, and infectious diseases are made from plant parts and plant oils. And then plants can also be used to make lotions and cosmetics, right? Makeup and certain things like that. Animal-based products are going to be synthetic products that are made from animals. Again, we only need to provide one example on our guided notes. There are three here for you. Animals can be used to make clothing. We use fibers from animals such as wool from sheep and cashmere from goats to make sweaters, coats, and other items. Animals can be used to make food. We use eggs from chickens, milk from cows as ingredients to make all sorts of food items. And another example is gelatin, which is a natural substance from animals. Gelatin is used as a gelling agent in foods such as ice cream and marshmallows, and it can be used to make shell of medical capsules in order to make swallowing pills easier. And then we have petroleum-based products. Petroleum-based products are synthetic products that are made from petroleum or from crude oil. Crude oil is also simply called oil. It's a fossil fuel. We use crude oil as a major source of energy. It is refined to make gasoline. So we use crude oil to make many other synthetic products as well. Three examples here. Again, you only need to give me one. Crude oil is used to make different kinds of plastics, including PVC, vinyl, and styrofoam. Crude oil is used to make nylon and polyester, which are often used in clothing. And crude oil is also used to make lubricants, waxes, and tar. Okay, and then the last portion of your guided notes is all about distribution of these natural resources. So Earth's natural resources are not distributed evenly across the planet. There are several factors that cause natural resources to be unevenly distributed. The three most important factors are number one being climate, number two being Earth's history, and number three being geological processes. All right, and that's it for today's video. If you need to go back to any portions that you missed to make sure you have your guided notes fully filled out, go ahead and do so now, and have a great day.